Dear teachers, hope you are doing well. I welcome you all in this program of Diploma in Elementary Education of NIOS. I am Dr. Ashish Srivastav, Associate Professor, Department of Education, Vishwa Bharati Shantiniketan, and I am the Academic Course Coordinator for the course 506, that is Understanding Children in Inclusive Context. Dear teachers, as you understand, this is very important paper, and this paper is having four blocks, viz. Block 1 deals with child growth and development, its basics. Block 2 deals with personality development of children. Block 3 deals with inclusive education, and block 4 deals with girl, child and child rights. While dealing with block 1, that is child growth and development, its basics, in this block, there are two units. Unit 1 deals with understanding the child, and Unit 2 deals with role of heredity and environment. In Unit 1, that is understanding the child, in this unit, you can understand the meaning of growth and development and describe the principles of growth and development. You can enlist the various factors responsible for growth and development. You can discuss different stages of growth and development and explain the role of teacher. In Unit 2, that is heredity and environment, in this unit, you can understand the meaning of heredity and environment. You will be able to discuss the mechanisms of heredity. You can enlist the various factors associated with environment. You will be able to know the relative role of heredity and environment and discuss their educational implications. Now come to block 2 that deals with personality development of children. This block is having four units. Unit 3 of this block deals with developing personality and its assessment. Next unit deals with developing thinking skills. Another unit deals with development of self. And last unit of this block deals with developing creativity in children. While dealing with unit 3, that is development of personality and assessment, this unit will help you to understand concept of personality and its nature. You can enlist the various characteristics of personality. You will be able to discuss some important theories of personality. In this unit, you can discuss various methods of assessing personality and role of a teacher in the personality development of students. While dealing with Unit 4, that is developing thinking skills, in this unit, you can describe the need of development of thinking skills in child. You will be able to discuss stages of thinking through Piaget's theory, Brunner's theory, and information processing theory. You will be able to discuss the role of school and teacher in development thinking skills. While dealing with Unit 5, that is development of self, in this unit you can understand development of self, concept in children and factors affecting it. You can define attitude and enlist its various components and also discuss the role of teacher in development of good attitude in children. While dealing with the next unit, that is development of creativity in children, in this unit you can understand the concept and nature of creativity. You can identify the different types of creativity in students and factors affecting creativity. You will know how to develop learning materials of fostering creativity as well as the role of ICT. You will be able to discuss creativity through various tools. Next block deals with inclusive education. In this block, we have four units to discuss. Unit first of this block deals with concept of inclusive education. Next unit of this block deals with concept of children with special need. Next unit of this block deals with education of children with special needs. And the last unit of this block deals with a development of adaptive skills, assistive devices, and special therapies. The first unit, that is introduction of inclusive education, in this unit, you will understand the concept and nature of special education, integrated education, and inclusive education. You can discuss various factors affecting inclusive education and classroom. You will know about learning material, physical environment, and classroom management in context to inclusive educational various disadvantaged groups, that is Dalit, Adivasi, girl, child, etc. Next unit, that is concept of children with a special need. In this unit, you will be able to define children with special needs. You can discuss early identification, its assessment, intervention, Also, you will know about various disability acts and policies, that is PWD Act 1995, the Rights of Persons with Disability Bill 2011. In the unit belongs to education of children with a special need. In this unit, you can understand educational challenges, learning characteristics and needs of children with special needs. You will empower to understand the use of suitable teaching learning material and ICT in inclusive classroom. Next unit deals with development of adaptive skills, assistive device, special therapies, and in this unit, you can understand the meaning of adaptive skills and assistive devices. You can identify adaptive skills and assistive devices for hearing impairment, speech impairment, multiple disability, cerebral palsy, and adaptations for learning disability, intellectual disability. The last block of this paper, this course 506, deals with girl, child, and child rights. In this block, we have three units. First unit of this block deals with gender discrimination. Second unit of this block deals with empowering girl children. And third unit of this block deals with child rights and entitlements. While dealing with gender issues in education, in this unit, you can understand the concept of gender, distinction between gender and sex. You can identify the sources, forms and causes of gender discrimination. You will know origin and history of gender discrimination and studies indicators of gender, sex ratio, education, health, etc. You will be able to discuss about the role of teachers in creating a gender fair society. In the next unit, that is empowering girl children, this unit will empower you to understand concept of empowerment, indicators of empowerment and need for empowering girls. You can discuss the role of education, the empowerment of girls. You can describe various qualities for empowering girls and you will be able to explain the role of various agencies in empowering women and girls. And in the last unit of this block, that is child rights and entitlements, this unit will help you to understand the meaning of human rights and rights of the child. You will be able to enlist the major recommendations of UN Convention regarding child rights. You can discuss Right to Education 2009 Act. You will need for abolition it. You can discuss the role of a teacher in protecting rights of the child and code of the conduct for this teacher. Dear teachers, I request for your active participation and I would appreciate your questions, queries, suggestions with me. I will be available for you on this same platform. Thank you so much.